Thank you. I'm sure there are more questions. Cannot answer everything. Thank you, sister. God bless you. Shall we move on? Shall I move on? Okay, so the last talk, then we're going to pray for you. The use and benefits of tongues, yeah? Okay. Remember, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, 16 to 18. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, 16 to 18. Can everybody read it? Come on, shall we read it? Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Famous passage. Very famous passage of St. Paul. I want to tackle the second point. Pray continually. Who wrote it? Paul. Pray continually. In some versions of the Bible, it says pray without ceasing. Without ceasing is what? Without stopping. Aha. Is it possible? Is it possible to pray without stopping? Is it possible to pray continually? Either he's saying the truth or this guy is a madman, St. Paul. We know one thing for sure in the life of St. Paul. He practiced what he preached. He preached what he practiced. Correct, no? Anybody? Yeah. He has done it. Because he's doing it, he's telling us. That is St. Paul. Very practical man. He never told his congregation to do something he never did. That is not St. Paul. So what does Paul mean when he says pray continually? Remember, we quoted the scripture previous session, 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 18. Remember? My dear Catholics, you remember? Last session. Yeah, 1 Corinthians 14, verse 18. What is it? Alzheimer's, is it? Alzheimer's? I thank God. I pray in tongues more than you all. That's why he's writing this. Pray more. So, listen to me carefully. Yeah? How many of you have read CCC, Catechism of the Catholic Church? Read it fully? Okay, sorry, that's a wrong question. Fully means no. Maybe just started first chapter and closed. A beautiful book, huh? You try to get it. Anyway, you read the Bible first, anyway. CCC tells us there are three forms of prayer. How many forms? Three forms of prayer. What are it? Number one is called vocal prayer. Number two is called meditation. Number three is called contemplation. Three forms of prayer. Are you with me? Hello? Oh, you have gone into contemplative mode? You know, because Catholics have a gift. You know what the gift Catholics have? They can keep their eyes open and sleep. Yeah? Listen to me carefully. Very important what I'm saying. You know what is vocal prayer? Vocal prayer is when you use your vocal cords. Am I right? Hello, are you with me? I want you to respond to, you know. Yes? Yeah. Charismatic spirituality is vocal prayer. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. May the Lord, may your name be blessed, Lord. What is it? Vocal prayer. You're using your vocal cords. Correct, no? I want to ask you a question. Can we pray vocal prayer continually? Yes or no? I want everybody to answer. Can we pray vocal prayer continually? Yes or no? No. No. If you pray vocal prayer continually, you lose your vocal cords. Correct, no? Are you with me? I'm driving a point. I'm driving a point. Wait, I'll tell you what it is. Can we pray vocal prayer everywhere and anywhere? Impossible. Imagine you went to fish market and you're praying vocal prayer. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Glorify your name, Lord. They will put a fish in your mouth and say, shut up. Shut up, they'll say. Useless fellow. Now listen to what I'm saying, a statement. I'm making a statement. This is not the prayer Saint Paul was saying, pray continually. Are you with me? Cannot pray continually. Second one, meditation. What is meditation? Meditation means when you meditate on the word of God. That is called meditation. Meditation is not looking at the mountain saying, God, how strong you are. Yeah. Looking at the sea, oh, so peaceful you are. Yeah, God is peaceful. You are not peaceful. Meditation is, when we use the word meditation, means meditating on the word of God. Sometimes we call it reflective reading. Reflective reading. We read and we reflect. We read and we meditate. Now the question is, can we do meditation continually? Hey, how can we do meditation? We are all lay people, and also we cannot. You pray, you work also. Nobody. Can you do meditation anywhere and everywhere? Hello, yes or no? No, sister. Impossible. Imagine, let me give an example. You are driving a car and you're trying to meditate on the word of God. If you do it, you will see God's face face to face. Very soon. If you want to see his face, I recommend that method. Not possible. You have to put a mind to it. You know what I'm trying to say? You have to put a mind. Listen to me. This is not the method Saint Paul was saying, pray continually. What is contemplation? Contemplation is this, according to the definition of CCC. I don't know what other religious and priests will say. This is the definition of CCC. Contemplation is contemplating the face of Christ. The face of Jesus, face of Christ. Contemplation is contemplating the face of Christ. Saint Teresa of Avila says, contemplation is a loving gaze on Jesus. It's contemplation. The question is, can you do contemplation continually? Unless you are a hermit. You cannot. Nobody can do contemplation continually. Continually. Impossible. Can you do contemplation everywhere and anywhere? No. You are driving and contemplating on Christ. You will see him face to face. Listen to me carefully. I know it's recorded. It's good. This is not what Saint Paul was saying. So what was Paul saying? If it is not vocal prayer, not meditation, not contemplation, what was Saint Paul saying? Pray continually. Gift of tongues. Why gift of tongues? Because gift of tongues, you can pray continually if you want. You can pray for 8 hours. You can pray for 12 hours. I know people who pray for 12 hours. My wife pray for 7 hours. Continually, if you want. Can you pray in tongues anywhere and everywhere? Yes. Hallelujah. So can you pray in tongues when you go to the fish market? Yes. Silently, of course. You pray, they put a fish again for you also. Can you pray in tongues when you're driving? Yes. Because you don't have to concentrate on what you're praying. Why? Your spirit is praying. Hallelujah. Praise God. That's how you can pray continually. So if I'm listening to somebody speaking, I travel across the world. So in the sense like I go to countries, I cannot understand their language. German, I don't know. Indonesia, I go to Indonesia, yeah, to preach. I've gone 25 times there to preach. I don't know Bahasa. When I'm at the Eucharist, I'm praying in tongues. I can't understand him. Nobody there to interpret for me. The interpreter also needs rest, you know, poor chap. He's interpreting me right through the mission. So you can pray in tongues anywhere, everywhere. That is the ability of gift of tongues. One. Second thing, all types of prayer, you need to go into a room, close the door and pray because of distraction. Hello, correct, no? Gift of tongues, you don't have to do it. You can be in the midst of distraction and pray in tongues. Yeah. You don't have to get into your room, close the door, pray. No, you're going for a morning walk, pray in tongues. Guru Varashandra. Here you get used to it. Your spirit gets used to it. Hallelujah. Your spirit, like you're breathing. Yeah, it'll pray. Amen? Amen. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now listen to this. What are the use and benefits? Very quickly. Very, very quickly. Number one, how can you use the gift of tongues? You can use the gift of tongues to praise and exalt God. In your own private... Okay, it's a good time to tell you this. Do you know what is the gift of prophecy? Okay, let me tell you, put it this way. All other gifts or all other charisms, St. Paul says, is for the common good of the church. Gift, that means it is a public use. Gift of tongues is for private use. Private. For yourself. Not meant for the building of the church. Yes. When you build yourself, yes, surely you also build the church. Yes. But it's more for building of yourself. Private prayer. So, you know, in the times of my personal prayer, 1 hour every day, I only pray in tongues. I pray in mind, I pray in the spirit. I pray in the spirit, I pray in my mind. Amen? I pray like that. That's how I pray. I travel on a flight, I pray in tongues. Continually. Yeah, I may sleep off. It doesn't matter, right? When I get up, the spirit reminds me. Start praying. I pray. Are you with me? Hello? So, you can praise God. For example, here, no? After the worship, we said, thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Exalt your name. Pray God. As a community, you can praise God. You can use the language to praise God. Everybody can pray in tongues. Privately, you can pray in your own prayer. You can exalt and praise God. Acts of the Apostles. Very important scripture. Do you know Acts chapter 10 is the story of a man called Cornelius. Have you heard of him? Cornelius. He was not a Jew. He was a Gentile. Who is a Gentile? Pagan. Non-Christian-like. Pagan. Pagan. Not a Jew. See what happens. The circumcised believers, that's the Jews, who had come with Peter, were astonished. Look at the word. Were astonished that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles. Who are the Gentiles? Unbelievers. They were astonished. The gift of the Holy Spirit was given even to Gentiles. How did they know it? How did they know that the Gentiles received the Holy Spirit? The next verse gives you the answer. They heard them speaking in tongues and praising God. Yeah. The Holy Spirit wouldn't touch everybody. The Holy Spirit is not no respecter of persons, you know. You want him, he will touch you. Any religion you are, he will touch you. He's the Holy Spirit. You can't put him in a box. You cannot. You can't put him in a structure. You can't put him on a prayer meeting. Charismatic renewal cannot say Holy Spirit is the monopoly of charismatic renewal. No, not. Holy Spirit is given to everybody in the church. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know what the Catholic Church says? The Catholic Church says, all Catholics who are baptized have received the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anything is we have to awaken the Holy Spirit. That's all. And if you pray in tongues like this, you'll awaken. Finished. You'll take control of your life. And your life will never, never be the same. See, praising God, you see, they use the gift of tongues to praise God. Look what now Peter is saying. Surely no one can stand in the way of them being baptized with water. Look at that. Uh-huh. They have received the Holy Spirit just as we are. Reverse. Reverse. They received the Holy Spirit and then they got baptized. Now for us, we get baptized and then receive the Holy Spirit. Isn't it? It changed. Holy Spirit can work how he wants. You can't tell Holy Spirit, sorry, you have to work only this way. Sorry. That's only for you. Reverse he worked. They were all praising God. So you can use the gift to praise God. Oh Lord, I praise you. You are an omnipotent God. You are an all-consuming God. You are a strong God. I praise you, Lord. For you are the God of the impossible in my life. You are an all-conquerable God. You can conquer every situation in my life, Lord. Oh Lord, that's praising God. Amen? So, leave this. Yeah, we already saw the scripture. Personal edification, number two. Are you okay? Are you feeling sleepy? Yeah. Thank you. I know it's afternoon session. It's not so easy, but you know what to do. We have to finish it, yeah? 1 Corinthians 14 verse 4. What is edification? What is the word edification? Strengthen. Edification means build up. To build yourself up, yourself. What does it say? He who speaks in a tongue edifies himself. You build yourself. How many people come and say, brother, I have no faith? You know why? Okay, let me ask you this question. How does faith come? Yeah? How does faith come? How does faith come? Faith comes. Yeah, that's why I'm saying, that's why you must read more of the word of God, no? Your answers are correct, but you don't do the word. Romans 10 verse 17, right? Romans 10 verse 17 says, faith comes by hearing the word of God. So you must hear the word of God. Pray and read the word of God daily. Faith will come. Faith will not come. I'm telling you, you can do what you want. I'm telling you, you can do any devotion in your life. Please listen to me carefully. I'm recorded. I like to be recorded. Nobody can dispute me later on. You can do any devotion. But only the word of God will bring faith into your life. Listen to me carefully. By all means, pray to who you want. You want faith to increase in your life? Read the word of God. It's not my word. Romans 10 verse 17 says, faith comes by hearing the word of God. Faith, it'll grow when you read, study, meditate on the word of God. There's no other way. Another way faith can come is by praying in tongues. Amen. Say hallelujah. He who speaks in a tongue edifies himself, builds himself. How do you build yourself? Spiritually. Why do you go? Why do men go to a gym? And nowadays women also go, right? Why do we go to a gym? Physically. When you pray in tongues, it's like spiritual gym. Muscles will come. Amen? Hallelujah. Spiritual muscles, of course. Yeah. We are prayed in tongues. That's why we could handle the crisis of our son. Yeah. We could have turned our back on God and said, God, no use following you. We left everything. We left our job. And this is the son you give us. Spy.
You know what made us to grow in the Lord? Tongues. We overcame a crisis. A crisis is a stepping stone to greater heights.
I'm here. Look at me. That's why I'm here. You know why? 1 Corinthians 14 verse 4. Praying in tongues. Built is. And how do you know your faith is grown? How do you know your faith is building? When you face a crisis. You can only test faith when you face a crisis. You will walk through it. You'll say, wow. I walked through this crisis. What is the difference? Your faith has grown. Otherwise this crisis would have buried you. That's the power of praying in tongues. Your faith will grow. Fruit of the Holy Spirit will grow, right? All the fruits of the Holy Spirit, you know. Galatians chapter 5, 22 and 23 will grow. It will grow. When you pray in tongues. You know, I am a very disciplined man. Highly disciplined. I'm a highly disciplined guy. It's good to be like that. But sometimes when you're highly disciplined, you make the lives of people around you miserable. Yeah. Why you came late? Look, it's not handled well. You didn't take care of this. Then who has lost peace? Me. I tell you the truth. You know what happened? I'm praying in tongues. 4-5 years now. Continually. Continually means 3-4 years. 3-4 hours. Internally, God has changed me. I was a short. You know what is a short tempered? You know what is the word short tempered? Yeah? Getting angry fast. Short tempered guy. Sometimes we say, no, he has no fuse. Have you heard of that word? No fuse. No fuse means he can get angry very fast. Don't talk to this guy. Oh my God. Hi. Thank you. Short fuse. Couples can be like that. Short fuse. Short fuse guy. If you pray in tongues, it will bring internal transformation into your life. Internal. Forget outside. Forget outside. Internal transformation. Once, I was at a retreat center preaching. I preached 3 days. Then the organizers came to me and they told me this. Brother, we forgot to book your return ticket. Can you believe it? In India, if you don't book your return ticket, you need to walk home. Normally, I would get a little angry. Bad organization, right? Obviously. But I was, you know, when you pray in tongues, it will surprise you. I wasn't surprised. Oh, okay. But they told me immediately, you know, we will do something. I said, okay. But I need to go home. After 1 hour, they came to me. This is what they told me. Brother, we'll do this. We will put you in a van. Tempo. It will take you to a place called Trishur. It's in Kerala, huh? Trishur. From there, brother, you catch one train. It will take you to a place called Podunur. From there, brother, you take a taxi. Go to Coimbatore. From there, I told them, I know how to go. Can you imagine? After preaching 3 days. So they put us in a tempo. With me, there were 5 other people from Bangalore. Tempo is going to Trishura. The train is at 6:30 p.m. The tempo is on the road at 6:30. My other friends panic. They told the driver, go soon. He said, sir, traffic, how can I go? I was surprised. You know what I was doing? Calmly sitting at the window, praying in tongues. I should have been like them. Normally, I'm like them. Even worse, I would have taken over the tempo. I'm praying in tongues. Lord, take care. So we arrived at the station, 6:40. Train delayed. Hallelujah. Thank God for Indian Railways. Hallelujah. They panicked, not I. Beautiful. Holy Spirit took control. the Spirit. He will make you more authentic. He'll make you transparent. He'll make you a good husband. He'll make you a good wife. I'm telling you. So easy, right? So easy, no? To be a saint to everybody outside, no? Isn't it? This husband, everybody else's wives love him except his own wife. See that? Look at that problem, no? Yeah. You know where you can get the best report of your life? Home. Community. In your community. Yeah. Outside, we're all saints. No problem. We're all saints outside. Wow. Who will work in your life? Holy Spirit. He will make your life transparent. He will make sure the light shines in your life so much that others will see the light in you and give glory to God. Amen. Say hallelujah. That is... Okay, leave this. Look at Jude. You know, there is one chapter of Jude in the Bible. You know that? Hello? Yeah. You can't even find it because it's only one chapter. That's why Jude is known as the saint for the hopeless cases. Yay. Jude 120, only chapter. See what Jude is saying. But you, dear friends, build, look at that, yourselves up in the most holy faith. Pray in the Holy Spirit. As you pray in the Holy Spirit, as you pray in tongues, you build yourself up. Spiritually matured Christian, you can overcome anything in your life. You will become more than a conqueror in Christ Jesus. Amen. Say hallelujah. That's how we have to be. We want to be victors, not become victims. Yeah. Look at this. When you pray in tongues, your health will become fruitful. Look at John. 3 John chapter 1 verse 2 says, dear friend, I pray that you may enjoy good health and all may go well with you, even as your soul is getting along well. I'll tell you one truth, sisters and brothers. When you are spiritually well, you will become physically well. Believe me. Amen? Say hallelujah. When you are spiritually well, you will become physically well. That's what St. John is saying. Fruitful health. I'm not under a single medication in my life. So is my wife. So is my son. Do you know my son is not even on a maintenance dose? Zero tablet. From 300 tablets to zero tablet. Hallelujah. When your soul is doing well, when you're spiritually good, you'll be physically good. Amen. You can use the gift of tongues for intercession. Yeah? So many people are in intercession ministry. Yeah, intercession. They love to pray. Praise God. But what better way to pray than to pray in tongues? Let's pray for the church. Do you have to explain? Nothing. Holy Spirit knows. You're praying for the church. Make a statement. You're praying for the church. Let us pray for our families. You don't have to make long prayers. Some people make such a long prayer, at the end of the prayer, they don't know what they prayed for. For what to make you such a long prayer? Deep intercession. The Spirit knows the need. Say the word of God. The Spirit within you knows the need and will pray according to the will of God. You know what prayer will get answered? Do you know what prayer will get answered? Amen. Prayer that is according to the will of God. And how to know it is going to be according to the will of God? Pray in tongues. If it is not according to the will of God, it will not get answered. Am I right? If it is according to the will of God, it will get answered. I like this passage. 1 John, write down. 1 John chapter 5 verse 14. 1 John chapter 5 verse 14 says, this is the confidence. Look at the way St. John is saying, this is the confidence we have in him, Christ. Whatever we ask according to his will, he will hear us. Amen. Say hallelujah. Not every prayer you're going to answer according to his will. That's why we need this, the prayer of tongues. It will purify your intention. Amen. Say hallelujah. 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 I met once a lady. You'll be shocked at this story. She's at a retreat. I'm just going to preach. She came to me. This is what she told me. Brother, I'm going through a huge problem in my marriage. So I thought it was her husband. She said, no, it's not my husband. My husband is a nice man. God has blessed me with a good husband. It's with my mother-in-law. You have a mother-in-law? God has put mother-in-laws, you know why? To purify us. Sandpaper ministry. Superiors. Rector. Finish you. Once I was preaching to sisters, and I told sisters, how good for sisters, no? Fathers, sisters and all. They're not talking with anybody. If they don't talk with anybody, they need to tolerate them for 3 or 4 years. That's all. Tolerate. After some time, they get transferred. What about married people? Is there a transfer? Married people, no transfer. Hello. If you're transferred, she also will come. May learn to make peace, sisters and brothers. Yeah, that is Christian life. Live in peace. Blessed are the peacemakers. They will be called the children of God. No use just coming for meeting, praying, not talking to your spouse, not talking to your mother-in-law, not talking to your sister-in-law. Hello, excuse me. What Christianity is that? Pray in tongues. This lady is telling me, brother, I said, why? She said, no, my mother-in-law, problem with my mother-in-law. I asked her, honey, how long have you married? Only 2 years. I told her, honey, you have a long way to go in life. Make peace with your mother-in-law. Come on. What Catholic are you? You go every day for Mass. You go for confession. You go for novena. You pray the rosary, but you can't live in peace? What Christian are you? That's a fake. That's why I'm saying the Holy Spirit will transform you inside out. That's the power of the Holy Spirit. So I asked this lady, pray for your mother-in-law. She said, I'm praying. Then I asked her, how are you praying? And what she told me surprised me. You know what she's praying? She's saying, brother, I'm praying God will take away my mother-in-law. Can you believe, brothers and sisters? Catholic. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. I don't know where they get this all, no? And she's at a retreat center making retreat. Maybe it would take your mother-in-law. What crazy, no? Imagine you go home. If you go home tonight and you pray, Lord, take away my mother-in-law. You know what will happen to your mother-in-law? She'll become stronger. She will become healthier. She will die after you. Be careful. Don't pray. This is not an attack, you know. And then we ask God, why God, you're not answering my prayer. Your prayer is stupid. It's not according to the will of God. This is what the Holy Spirit will do. When you pray in tongues, he'll give you the ability to live in peace. I'm not saying that everybody will become our friends. No, no, no. I'm not saying that. Jesus too had enemies. That's why he said, love your enemies. Yeah, but love your enemies. So intercede and pray. You can use, look at this gift, Romans 8:26. In the same way,
the Spirit helps us in our weaknesses. We do not know how we ought to pray, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us with groans that words cannot express. Amen. Say hallelujah. You know what St. Paul is saying? We do not know how to pray. Can you raise your hand? Anybody here? No, wait one sec. Listen to the question. You may not raise. Can anyone raise your hand and say, I know how to pray? Raise your hand. Sister? Nobody. That's why Paul is saying we do not know how to pray. We don't know how to pray. That's why we need to rely on the Holy Spirit. We don't know. And then he says, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us. Look at that. Holy Spirit that is within us will intercede for us with groans. So the best way to pray, intercession, is to pray in tongues. Best way. The Holy Spirit is praying. I pray for my family, pray in tongues. I pray for my son, I pray in tongues. I pray for my job, I pray in tongues. That's how it is. And if it is according to the will of God, so, you know, intercede for your family, friends. Okay, leave it, yeah? Look at this. What prayer? The Holy Spirit, when you pray in tongues, and he, the Holy Spirit, who searches our hearts, knows the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for God's people in accordance with the will of God. Say hallelujah. Say hallelujah. Yeah. The Holy Spirit knows what to pray for. He'll pray according to the will of God. If you come this evening and ask me, please pray for me, and I say yes, what will I pray for you? Lord, give him a wife. He already has one. What a wrong prayer to make, no? What will I do? I'll pray in the Spirit. I don't know your need, yeah? I don't know your need, but who knows your need? Holy Spirit. I should know. I don't have to know. That's why you believe me. Today I pray for people 30 seconds. I don't make long prayers. When people come to me and they try to explain their situation, I tell you, I don't want it. I don't want medical history. Don't tell me your medical history, I tell people. I don't want to know your medical history. What is your problem? Let me pray for you in tongues. Close. The Holy Spirit knows. Amen? Amen. Holy Spirit knows. Otherwise, it'll take too long, isn't it? How long to pray for people? 1,000 people are there. How to pray for them? 30 seconds. Holy Spirit knows. Pray in tongues. All the Holy Spirit knows. Holy Spirit knows. Amen? Say hallelujah. So if your people are in intercession ministry, use it more. You will see breakthroughs. Amen. Others will pray, and you will just pray, and you will just pray, and you will just pray. Same intercessions are going for the last 2,000 years. No answer has come. What's the point? Who are you praying to? We are going to leave this. We are going to do this. Remember, we talked about speech already, yeah? The Holy Spirit. You see, when you pray in tongues, the Holy Spirit will sanctify your speech. You will bless people, not curse them. Amen. You will talk good about them. You won't gossip about them. Amen. Yeah. Holy Spirit will do that for you. He will transform your language. He'll transform your tongue. He'll sanctify your tongue. Make it holy. And then he will start using you in mission. Yeah. Isaiah chapter 6. He wanted to go on mission. Isaiah chapter 6 verse 4. God said, no, Isaiah, wait. I have to sanctify you. And God put a, through an angel, brought a coal, burning coal, touched his lip, touched his tongue. And then God asked, who will go for me? Isaiah said, here am I, Lord. Send me. You know what God said? Go. Because we are proclaiming the word of God through our lips. And the Holy Spirit will transform your speech when you pray in tongues. Yeah, we are going to leave this, yeah? We don't have time for this. Not required. Divine revelation will come. Amen? Amen? Say hallelujah. Are you with me? Are you fading like a flower? Divine revelation and insight and secrets will come as you read the word of God. Amen? Say hallelujah.
Listen to me carefully. This is not a Bible now. This, imagine this is a book. I give this book. From where will you start reading? First chapter. Correct, no? Now this is a Bible. I give it to read. And I say, read the Bible. Where will you start? First chapter. And that's the mistake. People don't tell us how to read the Bible. Where you should start is in the New Testament. Start from the Gospels. Don't start from Genesis. People read. They read Genesis, then they read Deuteronomy, then they read Numbers, then they read Leviticus, and then they died. Come on. Brother, boring. You're reading the wrong chapter, sir. If you read Numbers, you will become carpenter. Yeah. Read what first? New Testament, the Gospels. Read the New Testament once, twice, thrice. Then go to the Old Testament. It will become meaningful. Don't start in the Genesis. Read the Gospels. Why Gospels? The life of Christ. Who will bring life to us? Jesus, not Moses. Hello. Are you with me? Who is greater, Moses or Jesus? Who is greater, Jesus or Joshua? Who is greater, Jesus or Daniel? Who is greater, Jesus or Isaiah? Read more about Jesus. He is the one who is going to save you, not Moses. He is the one who is going to save you, not Joshua. You know that? I'm not against Moses. I'm not against Joshua. God bless me. Moses, when I come, please. But I'm telling the truth. Jesus will save you. Of course, must read the Old Testament, surely. But first read the New Testament. Once, twice, thrice, go to the Old Testament. Meaningful. Insight. As you pray in tongues, the same Bible that is boring will come alive. Why? You know the author now. Who is the author? Holy Spirit. Amen. Once I was preaching at a youth convention, and this is where the youth convention asked me, a Divine Retreat Center, right? In July they have a youth convention. It's called, you know, it's called the International Power or something they call it, yeah? And I'm a regular preacher there, and every time I go there, they'll ask me to give one talk. I mean, I give many talks, but this is a must. Called Christian Relationships. Boy-girl relationship. Huh? When to marry, when not to marry, da-da-da-da-da. So I developed a good talk. I became very famous for it. You go on YouTube, listen to the talk. You laugh also. But those who are married, you can't do anything much. Yeah? Okay. This time I went, the organizers told, brother, you must give the talk. Huh? Relationships. I said, sure, no problem. It's already there. PowerPoint. But I felt, you know what? I must change the title. Talk is the same. Title. So what I did is I put love, sex, marriage. Wow. Because my talk was 2 o'clock in the afternoon. When I put love, sex, marriage, all the youth are alive. So I caught them. I put love, sex, marriage, first slide. I went to the chapel to pray before I went to preach. When I went to pray, the Holy Spirit told me, wrong topic. I said, what? Why is it wrong topic? Love, sex, marriage. I've heard many talks like this when I was growing as a youth. Love, sex, marriage. The Holy Spirit told me, it's the wrong order. It should be love, marriage and sex. Hallelujah. How beautiful. That's the power of the Holy Spirit. If you pray, He will correct all this for you. Correct, no? That is the order, no? God designed that order, what? Love, marriage and sex. That's the order. You cannot change the order. That is the power of the Holy Spirit. He will give you wonderful new insights and, you know, various things. Okay, yeah? Let's move into this. Okay. Look at John 16 verse 13. We'll leave the rest. But when He, the Spirit of truth, comes, He will guide you into all the truth. He will not speak on His own. He will speak only what He hears,
and he will tell you what is yet to come.
Look at that.
The Holy Spirit will show you your future. The Holy Spirit will show you your future. Look at the last line. He will tell you, Holy Spirit, what is yet to come. Yet to come. Holy Spirit.
If you pray to the Holy Spirit, he will tell you your future. Amen. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, he'll reveal the future. That's why the Holy Spirit is so important. Yeah? Last point.
He'll bring breakthrough.
Amen. Say hallelujah.
When you pray in tongues, amazing breakthroughs. Breakthroughs you have not seen in your life. You're praying for something for years.
You pray in tongues, you'll get a breakthrough. Amen. Look at this man. Quickly, I share his story. This man was in the hospital. He had contacted H1N1. You know what is H1N1? Swine flu, right? Hello? Many people, this happened in the place called Coimbatore. You know Coimbatore, right? It's close to Chennai. Okay. One sec. I think they are. Just my sweat. Okay. And 2017 story. Many people in 2017, January, February, contacted H1N1 swine flu in Coimbatore and were dying. This guy contacted swine flu and they put him in the hospital, ICU. The doctors told him, sorry, 20% for you to live. All are dying. One day, someone, I don't know who, told his wife, why don't you call Priya? Priya is my wife. She will pray for you on the phone. So this lady called up my wife one day and told Priya, can you pray for my husband? He's like this. So Priya prayed for her on the phone. Then every day at 4 o'clock, my wife used to take the phone and pray for his wife. He's in the ICU. 20 days. My wife will pray in tongues. On the phone, right? One day my wife asked this lady, do you pray in tongues? This lady said, no. I belong to the CSI church. You know what the CSI church? It's called the Church of South India. It's not a Catholic church, Protestant church, yeah? Church of South India. She said, no, sister, I don't pray in tongues. Our church doesn't preach in tongues. They don't tell us about tongues. They don't believe in tongues. We are just like Catholics, she's saying. Can you imagine? Catholics are famous for the wrong reason. And my wife told her, you know, Sheba, I'm a different Catholic. I pray in tongues. Do you want to receive the gift? This girl told her, Sheba told her, sister, if it's going to help me, I'm open to it. So my wife prayed on the phone. And she received the gift of tongues in Coimbatore. Started praying in tongues. And something happened. This lady started praying so much in tongues that the other nurses in the hospital, I don't know what they saw in her life, came to her for prayer. Her husband is ICU. Can you imagine? Some days later, the doctors called Sheba and told Sheba, your husband, his eyes have closed. It's an indication to us he will not live more than 3 hours. Please go and see your husband. So Sheba went to the ICU. There are nurses there also. You know what Sheba did? You see, when you pray in tongues, it edifies yourself, it builds your faith. You know what Sheba did? Amazing woman. She prayed like this. Her husband's eyes are closed. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command your eyes to open. And she prayed in tongues. Her husband's eyes opened immediately in the hospital. Say hallelujah. When the nurses saw it, they asked Sheba, Sheba, who did you pray to? She said, Jesus, my Lord. The doctors who were in the next room
heard it and came running into the hospital. They looked at this guy, his eyes are open. They asked Sheba, who did you pray to? She said, Jesus.
You know what happened to his life? Here is it. He got discharged. Look at him. Here.
Fully healed.
Discharged. Say hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. 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 This is the power. No intervention from us. Power of the Holy Spirit. The story does not end. You know his medical bill? He was 4 months in the ICU or 3 months, something like that in the ICU. His medical bill was 38 lakhs. 38 lakhs. Sheba writes in her testimony to us, in a supernatural way, God brought